I was just like, kind of always thought that it'd be cool to fight same card with my son. And they made it happen. You know, he's on a hell of a win streak. He's 14-0. I'm in great shape for this age. I'm just happy and blessed to be able to do what I do, man. Man, I'm excited. There's no lose. There's no nervous energy. I'm a veteran in the sport. I've been doing this for a long time. I've trained the best in the world. I've rolled with the best in the world. I'm just happy to be able to sit next to my son and fight the same night. I mean, that's history being made on American soil right there. You know what I mean? It's just never been really done at this level. I'm not talking about like, okay, some dad and two kids, they fight. I'm talking about really at the top of the food chain. I think I can make a run for the title at 155.
And for my dad to be at the age he is still competing, you know, it's kind of phenomenal. So I'm just looking forward to going out there. You know, there's a lot on the line for me. My record's on the line. Bellator longest win streak's on the line. So it's the first round of $1 million tournament. So it's a lot, you know. I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a great night. It's bringing recognition to my family and my last name, you know, the McKee last name and the fight game, you know. My dad's been around just as long as damn near the fight game. So a lot of people just don't know him. But I'm making sure that last name McKee is well known in the sport.
It's in his blood. We're all fighters. The McKee whole foundation is about fighting. I got a 2-year-old that's already fighting. My dad was a professional boxer. I was a fighter. My son's a fighter. I think he's just in the lineage of the McKees.
I'd be a mercenary. Real talk. Yeah. I'm special with guns, dude. My first time picking up an AR, I was hit 800 yards out. So, like, I pick guns up, take them apart, put them back together. I got a thing with guns, speed, anything adrenaline, that or like a race car driver. You know, I'd be a, you know, I got an 88 CRX B18 turbo fully built, 700 horsepower Honda. So it's no toy. That's a monster.
Man, Scott Coker's an amazing guy. You know, I've always said he's a good guy. He's there for the fighters. He's there for the fighters more than he is there for the brand Bellator. And I think that's why Bellator is doing so well. The only thing I would just, you know, complain about is he develops talent, but he doesn't build superstars. The UFC just kind of has a niche on it right now. But I think we're going to make a superstar. I think AJ will be the first superstar out of Bellator. He's home fed and grown there. A lot of time to grow and get better. But I believe, other than that, Scott's awesome, man. They take really good care of the fighters. It's just a pleasant place to be. You see Cyborg, she's leaving. She's now over there. That was all part of the plan anyway.
MMA is my art. It's a little different. For other people, it may be an adrenaline rush, you know. For me, it's like, it's an art. It's like centering my chi. When I go in that cage, it's something different. I kind of just, I go somewhere else, you know. My whole mind goes somewhere else. And I don't know, I just feel things. I can feel where people are at. I can, like, you know, it's like an art. It's mixed martial arts. But for me, it's something different. You know, I go in there and I have fun, you know. So I'm looking forward to this fight. You know, it's $1 million on the line. I haven't really had to fight. I haven't pulled out John Jones kicks or started throwing elbows. But for $1 million on the line, I'm looking forward to throwing some crazy stuff and hurting some people so I don't get hurt. There's not too many people that fight like me, and that's why people have a problem training for me. They don't know what the hell I'm going to do. With the art, you don't know. I'm not going to go out there and throw a 1-2, a 1-2-3, 1-2-3-4. I'm going to go out there and throw a spinning wheel kick, or I might take you down, or I might try a flying triangle. Like, you never really know, you know? So that's the whole – it's just about being comfortable, you know, being comfortable in your art enough to go out there and showcase your skill. It's the build-up until that now moment. You know, sometimes you train 8 weeks for a 39-second knockout. I mean, that's what you train for, but it's like, is it worth it? It's worth every second of it, you know? So I've kind of learned now it's better to be prepared than to be unprepared.
Well, I remember I was in Russia and I was out there by myself, and I'm fighting the number one guy. He's a national champ over there, and he's tough, and I'm fighting him. And I go out there, and I said, okay, you know what? I've always been known for my great ground and pound in wrestling. I'm going to stand up and strike with this guy. I stood up and striking with him. We're going back and forth. Next thing you know, I'm on the ground and I look up and I'm like, hey, what's going on? How did I get here? Then I realize, oh, I must have got hit. I heard the crowd's cheering. And I look up and he's coming down to get on top of me. And he gets on top of me and I go, well, let me just get up. And I couldn't get up. The guy was heavy. I was fighting 170. So I'm trying to get up and I realize, wait a minute. I must have got hit. And all I can remember was, you know what? I can't go home and tell my daughter I lost. And I got up and I ended up beating the guy really good. But to me, that was probably the best one because I was out of another country. I was all by myself. And I thought about my daughter to win.